Sometimes you may experience that this Godox X2T trigger is not sending a firing signal to the flash. When that happens, the first thing you need to check is if the batteries in the trigger are charged. If they don't have enough power, in that case you need to change the batteries or change them and use them later. The second thing you need to check is if the batteries in the flash have enough power. If they don't, then there's going to be a delay. There's going to be a delay in the recycle time, which means that if you have set your flash to full power, when you fire, it is going to take a few seconds before the flash is ready to fire again. If you try to fire within that period, then the flash is not going to fire. Another thing you need to check is that the group and the channel in the trigger and in the flash are set correctly. If it is group A, channel 5, it should be so both in the flash and in the trigger. The next thing you need to check when you go to menu, you can see that there is distance. There is 1 to 100 meters and 0 to 30 meters. If you select 0 to 30 meters and your subject happens to be farther away than that distance, then it is also not going to fire. The last thing you need to check is if the channel you are using is receiving disturbances from elsewhere. For instance, you could be using a channel that is receiving disturbances from a Bluetooth device or even a Wi-Fi network. In that case, you need to scan and select a new channel that is not experiencing any form of disturbances. Those are some of the things you need to check if your flash and trigger are not syncing and they are not firing.